In this video, we're going to learn how to determine if a word is an N-word or an ett-ord. Låt oss börja.
Hej och välkomna till Coffee Break Swedish. Jag heter Mark.
Och jag heter Lovisa.
And as Lovisa said, we're going to be answering a question about ett-words and N-words today. In fact, we've had this question from two different people. Diego and Bill both got in touch asking, how do I know if a word is an N or an ett-word? So, Lovisa, how do we know?
Yeah, we actually don't have a rule for this. So most of the time, we're just going to have to learn. But we do have a few little things that we can use to help us sort of guess if it's an N-word or an ett-word.
Okay, so what is the first rule? There's not a rule, but what's the first thing we need to think about?
Most of the words that we come across are actually N-words. So in general, maybe 80% of all the nouns that we have in Swedish are N-words, and maybe 20% are ett-words.
Okay, so that's our first thing. 80% N-words, 20% ett-words. Okay, good stuff. That's useful to know immediately.
And then it's also good to keep in mind that in general, all things that all living things tend to be N-words. So people, animals, all things like that. But we do have a few exceptions to this rule.
Right. Okay. So far we've got living things, any living things, people, animals, these tend to be, you said, N-words, yeah?
Yeah.
But you said there are exceptions.
Yeah. So I make it easy. Okay. So for example, the word for an animal. Mm-hmm. Is ett-djur.
Ett-djur. So ett-djur. Okay, so that's an animal. It's a living thing, but it's still an ett-word.
Exactly. And we also have a specific type of animal. Mm-hmm. So ett-lejon, a lion, is also an exception.
Okay, ett-lejon. Right, mm-hmm. So another exception. What else?
We have a child, mm-hmm. ett-barn.
Something we've come across many times in Coffee Break Swedish, ett-barn. So a mm-hmm. child. Also an ett-word.
And then we also have ett träd, which is a tree.
Ett träd. Okay, so ett träd, a tree. Okay, I should really be drawing pictures here, but I've not got time, so we'll not draw any pictures. But those are some common exceptions. These are all living things. Let's just go through them one more time. An animal.
Ett djur.
A lion.
Ett lejon.
A child.
Ett barn.
And a tree.
Ett träd.
So even though these are living things, they are still ett-words, okay?
Yes.
Most living things are N-words, but these ones are ett-words. Is there any other way to kind of guess? Can we make an educated guess about some words?
Yeah. We also have a lot of nouns that aren't people or animals or living things at all mm-hmm. that are N-words.
Right.
And we can sort of guess which words are N-words or ett-words, depending on the letters that they end with.
Okay. A group of letters or a single letter?
We're going to use a couple of letters.
Okay, so we're looking at the last two letters of mm-hmm. particular words. So what are these letter combinations that will result in N-words?
Yeah, we start off with the combination K-A.
Okay. K-A. Give mm-hmm. us a couple of examples then.
We have en kyrka.
En kyrka. So let's just think about this. En kyrka means a church. A church.
Yes.
The building is not necessarily a living thing. However, no. This word is an N word because it ends in ka.
Exactly.
Okay.
We also have another example. So let's say en persika.
En persika. We've seen this before. En persika. So a peach. Another theoretically, well, it's not a living thing. Once upon a time it was. Depends whether you're eating it or not. So in persika, a peach, but again, it ends in K-A, therefore we're making that an N word. Right, that's good. What other combinations might we be looking for?
We have L-A as well.
Ah, okay, L-A. Mm-hmm. So what about any examples there?
Well, we have the word skola, which we've come across before.
Yeah, a school. So in skola. Another N-word ending in L-A. So although it's not in that category of people or animals, we're making an N-word. Okay, one more example.
We can say the word semla as well, which is a very traditional pastry.
Yeah, it's the one with the cream on top, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly.
Excellent. And semla. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Anything else?
We can move on to the third letter combination,
mm-hmm.
which is N-A.
N-A. Okay. Can I guess one here? Because there's one that comes to mind. En stjärna.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's a perfect example.
So en stjärna, that is a star. Okay. Anything else?
We can also say en krona.
Ah, okay. So literally a crown, but of course also the currency. So en krona.
Yeah. And then the fourth letter combination is ng.
Ng. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So what would we have there?
We can stick with the theme of crowns, and we can have the word kung.
En kung, okay. En kung, a king. Right.
Yes.
Anything else?
Also sort of on the theme of crowns and currency, en peng.
What is en peng? That's new for me.
Yeah, en peng means money, or like one krona is en peng.
Ah, like a coin.
Yes.
Excellent. Okay, there's room for one more here. Do we have one more group?
We do have one more group. We have RE as well.
Right. Okay, RE. So these are all N words, even though they don't fall into the living things category. So what are the examples here?
We're going to look at two professions. So we have the word en bagare.
En bagare. I'm going to guess, is that a baker?
Yes, that's right.
Okay.
And then we have en förare.
Oh, we've come across that. En förare.
Do you remember what it is?
Is it a driver?
Yeah, exactly.
Some kind of driver. Right. Okay. So let's quickly summarize here. 80% of all Swedish nouns are N words, and about 20% are ett words.
Yes.
And the next thing that we need to decide is it a living thing? If it's a living thing, the chances are it's going to be an N word. However, there are those exceptions: an animal, ett djur, ett lejon, a lion, ett barn, a child, and ett träd, a tree. Yes. So far, so good?
So far, so good.
Okay, but then we have another group of non-living things that are definitely N-words. Can we run through these again? So a church.
En kyrka.
A peach.
En persika.
Both of those ending in K-A. School.
En skola.
And a cream bun.
En semla.
Okay, so those are ending in L-A. Words ending in N-A.
En stjärna.
A star. And then a crown.
En krona.
Okay, and then our NG words, so a king.
En kung.
And a coin.
En peng.
And last group, our RE words, a baker.
En bagare.
And lastly, a driver.
En förare.
Fantastic. Well, Diego and Bill, we hope that that has helped you. It certainly helped me work out which words are N words and it words. If you have a question like Diego or Bill, then do get in touch with us. Send your questions to coffeebreakquestions.com, or at least go to coffeebreakquestions.com, fill in the form there, and we'll hopefully be able to include your question in a future episode of the show. And if you've enjoyed this, if you've learned something today, then please give our video a like, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Also, hit the little bell icon that appears, and that way you'll be notified whenever we post a new video.
And also, why not put your favorite examples of en och ett words in the comments?
Jättebra. Tack så mycket, Lovisa.
Tack så mycket, Mark.
And thank you to Diego and to Bill for your question. We shall be back soon. Vi ses.
Vi ses. Hej då.